Maganda umaga po sa inyong lahat. What are your fears? Sometimes, you know, we act like as if wala na tayong kinatatakutan dito sa mundo. Pero may mga takot pa rin tayo, kahit tayong mga Kristiyano. We have just learned which ones to prioritize. If we look at our life's priorities right now, one by one, our fears are unmasked. If your priority now is money, you are afraid to have nothing. If your priority is your title or your position, you are afraid to be no one. If your priority now is worldly, you are more afraid of losing this life in this world than gaining life in the next. And we all see that too often nowadays. We would either do all that we can to conquer these fears, even at the expense of our souls, or if we cannot, we will medicate them to make us forget. Our generation is obsessed with conquering lesser fears, but forgetting that one fear that matters the most. In our gospel today, Jesus tells us to fear nothing, to fear no one, not even those who can kill the body but cannot kill the soul. But he tells us to be afraid of one thing, the one who can destroy both body and soul in Gehenna. Pag naiisip natin yon, first thing that might come into our mind is hell or the devil or punishment or God's wrath for our sins. But I think this is not what Jesus is pointing out. Because God condemns no one to hell. We condemn ourselves to hell by choosing sin, by not being afraid of deliberately cutting ourselves from God. Sin which destroys both body and soul in Gehenna or hell. Kaya nga tanungin natin ang ating mga sarili, takot pa ba tayong magkasala o parang wala na lang sa atin? At kung takot tayong magkasala, takot ba tayo dahil natatakot tayong maparusahan tayo? O natatakot tayo kasi masasaktan natin o tatalikuran natin ang tunay na nagmamahal sa atin? You know, our lesser fears, when we allow them to take over our lives, they are amplified, making them our greatest fears and the greatest driving force in our life. And so that makes us blind of the one healthy fear that matters. Fear of the Lord. Fear of being cut off from the one who really loves us and who wants the best for us. With society having lost God as the proper object of healthy fear, our culture is necessarily becoming even more neurotic, ever more anxious about the unknown. In fact, we are ever more anxious and afraid about anything and about everything. However, if we allow the fear of the Lord to be our life's driving force, this fear will become the beginning of wisdom according to the book of Proverbs. And what is this wisdom? It is to see things in God's perspective, in the eyes of the divine love. In other words, to see and to know God's will. At yun naman talaga ang hinahanap natin dito sa mundo. Most of us just don't know it yet because our lesser fears makes us seek other things. His will is always the best for us, far greater and far better than what the world can offer. And you can only know God's will for you if you grow in wisdom, and wisdom begins in fear of the Lord, to come and follow the Master's command in obedience. My dear brothers and sisters, if we tremble and rejoice daily before God, fearing Him above all else, remember this, all other fears begin to seem just a little less terrible. This is the strange paradox, that the gospel both frees us from fear and gives us fear. It frees us from our crippling fears, but giving us instead the most delightful, happy, and wonderful fear of the Lord. And so, my dear brothers and sisters, our world seems scary, and many of us are still burdened with many fears and anxieties. But as we bring them daily to God, who knows us and loves us through and through, over time, He will help us put these lesser fears in their proper place. Because when we fear God, we have nothing else left to fear. Amen.